Good afternoon. The first meeting of the sixth session of the Parliament is now resumed with the election of the presiding officer. Only one nomination was received, and accordingly, as Alison Johnston MSP was the sole nominee, the election shall proceed in accordance with temporary rule 1.12 of standing orders. Members may vote for or against that candidate or to abstain. The candidate shall be elected if a simple majority of votes in the candidate's favour is obtained. Ballot papers should be marked with an X before being folded, and the clerks will then collect each ballot paper and place them in the ballot box for you. At the end of the voting period, I shall invite any scrutineers nominated by the nominee to monitor the counting of votes in room P102. There, the clerks will empty the ballot boxes and begin counting votes. I will announce the result of voting when the vote is counted and verified. To ensure everybody's safety is in line with the COVID-19 protocols, could I ask all members to put their face coverings on now, please? All members can do that, unless, of course, you have a medical exemption. Thank you, colleagues. I now declare the election of the presiding officer open, and I'll ask the clerks to begin distributing the ballot papers. Yeah, this is hiding behind the ears. Thank you. Thank you, colleagues. The voting for the presiding officer's election is now closed. The clerks will now take the ballot boxes to P102, and I would invite any scrutineers appointed by the candidate to make their way to P102 to observe the counting of ballot papers while observing social distancing. And I can say to members that you may now remove your face coverings.
I'm going to come with my back. Presiding. Will we just get all the boxes open? Do you want them all open this one time?
Yeah, just get them all open and then we'll.
Sorry?
with them.
Thank you, colleagues. Thank you, colleagues. In the election of the presiding officer, there was one candidate, Alison Johnson, MSP, and the number of votes cast was as follows. Yes, 97. No, 28. There were two abstentions. There was one spoiled paper. And Alison Johnson is therefore duly elected as presiding officer of the Scottish Parliament. Now, may I be the first to formally offer Alison my warmest congratulations. And as she is one of the members sitting in the main hall of the Parliament, may I ask our newly elected presiding officer to make her way to the debating chamber, yes, and to take the place in her chair for the remainder of this meeting. Alison Johnson, please make your way to the debating chamber.
Thank you, everyone. That means a lot. I'm very, very grateful. I'm sorry I didn't have a contest today, but I'm very proud to be in this position. For those of you who don't know, I joined Scotland Forward, the campaign for a devolved parliament, before I joined the Scottish Green Party. That was back in the late 90s. It's just such a very important place for me. I was then really fortunate to get a job with Robin Harper, who was the first elected Green parliamentarian in the UK here in 1999. So I've been in this building in a couple of guises, and it's been an absolute privilege to serve as a Scottish Green Party representative for Lothian Region. And I'd really like to just take this opportunity to thank my little staff team of Sally, Dan, Richard and Helen, and all of those who have contributed in any way during the years, because that team has changed. I'd also like to thank my Scottish Green Party colleagues and my party and everyone who's worked on such a fabulous election campaign. But here today, I've been afforded a great opportunity and an incredible privilege, and one that I will never, ever take for granted. And before I forget, I'd also like to thank my very patient and tolerant family. I think you've afforded me the opportunity to take on a major challenge at an incredibly important time in Scotland's history. We face various challenges. We're just coming out of the end, we hope, although, you know, we hear worrying statistics on a daily basis of a pandemic that has affected the lives of each and every one of us. We've lost loved ones, people have lost livelihoods. It's a very, very challenging time for us all, and it's the duty of the government and the parliament to do everything that we can to make sure that those living in Scotland have the best lives that they possibly can, that we continue to work together and cease to reduce inequality and poverty. I want to encourage a culture of open debate in this parliament. I think we should be able to have that debate, but I'd like to do so in an atmosphere of inclusivity, mutual tolerance and respect. I think it's absolutely fabulous that in this new session I see more diversity. I mean, it's absolutely clear, and that is welcome. We see, you know, more people from minority ethnic backgrounds. I see far more women. This is fabulous progress, but we're not there yet. And, you know, I think I know from Husting with Pam Duncan-Glancy that we have a real champion there for people, for disabled people. But we can do better. I mean, I think we need to get to the stage where this parliament truly represents all people in Scotland, people from the LGBT community, so that we really mirror those who live in our streets and in our neighbourhoods. There are challenges ahead, of course. We are in the midst of the nature and the climate emergency. You know, as well as the pandemic, we have to tackle them. Our young people have done such a fabulous job bringing this issue to life. They've helped us, you know, they've helped ensure that we adults debate it properly on their behalf. We only have a few years to act, and I think it's really important that Scotland makes the most of the opportunity that COP26 will provide. I will do my very best to make sure that each and every one of you has an opportunity to best represent your constituents, your interests and everything that is important to you. I obviously recognise a lot of old faces. I mean, experienced faces. There's a lot of new faces too. And we're all going to have an opportunity to get to know one another better over the next few weeks, months and years. But I just want to assure you that I will do my very best in this role, as Ken McIntosh has done. I mean, obviously, you know, very large shoes to fill. And I think he's done an exceptional job, for which I am very grateful. But thank you all. Thank you. Thank you. I'm now pleased to announce, this is announcement of the election of the Deputy Presiding Officer. So nominations for the positions of Deputy Presiding Officer open at 9 a.m. tomorrow. Details of the process for submitting nominations will be set out in the business bulletin. Nominations must be submitted no later than 10 a.m. tomorrow morning. And after the nomination period has closed, members will be notified of the names of the nominees. So I will resume this meeting of Parliament at 10:30 a.m. for the election of the Deputy Presiding Officers. and I suspend this meeting of Parliament. Thank you.